How's that? I fought Renzo Gracie 6 days or 8 days after I fought Marco Ruas.
Right, that's right. So that Ruas fight was, Chris, Miguel, I'm telling you, like, I watched the whole thing. It looked like a bare knuckle boxing event. And Ruas, in my opinion, like, if you look at the damage, total of damage, the Oleg took a lot of damage in that fight. And when they announced the Renzo Gracie bout, as a fan of Oleg and thinking, God, someone's going to get the Gracie, someone's going to expose him. Like, I'm like looking, you know, thinking the gods of war that Oleg is going in there against Renzo. But then I watched the, you know, the Marco Ruas rematch, and I couldn't believe that you were able to even step in the ring that night based on the totality of the damage you had against Ruas.
My the way I was raised. You give a word, you keep it, and sometimes you just have to be more tricky in this thing. I had my hand broke, like right here.
For sure.
In the Mark Ruas fight. He broke his hand in 10 minutes. I broke his my hand over his forehead on a 17 minutes. And I couldn't understand what's going on there. Like, I couldn't shake his hand. And the guy who put the money for Mars, that Renzo Gracie fight, he was a doctor. And I told him, hey, can you please look at my hand? I mean, something is wrong. I mean, I can't squeeze it. And he looked at this. I see something is moving there. He said, no, it's okay. I took X-ray when I got home, and there was a bones just flowing. So it was there was a criminal act on his part. But I never sued him. I never actually even tried to contact him, because this was not the worst thing. Because I still would probably fight Renzo Gracie with one hand and still be okay. It still could be, no contest or something. I mean, I saw no way I could lose that fight. But we had a very two interesting men, promoters. One was a Tom, another, don't remember what his name. So those guys, they did something that no one in the MMA community, in the MMA promotion, should never do. They hire a manager in Miami, who got the guy, Alex Rafalski, who was not a fighter. He was a veteran of Afghanistan war. Concussions, being in prison. So that was just his way to get close to the fighters. And 2 hours before the fight, we're drinking tea. He said, oh, this is Russian tradition. Let's sit all in a rounded table. Let's drink a tea and to good fight. And all the guys who fought that night, they were not professional fighters. There were some taxi drivers, someone masseuse, some construction workers, and just got names. So they want to show that Samba is bad, but none of those guys were Samba guys except me. And then 30 minutes before the fight, they come to me, Oleg, I mean, I feel so sleepy. Like, before I was nervous, now I feel like I don't give a fuck. I mean, I feel like I don't care what was going on. Like, I want to just go sleep. I said, don't worry about it. It's okay. It's always like this. You'll be okay. Once you get in the ring, we'll be fine. But I'm asking myself, yeah, you're right. You know? Why am I feeling like I'm just somewhere? I'm not sure where. Like, I'm living a different life. So basically, that fuck put sleeping pills or I'm not sure what he put in the tea.
In your tea.
And whole team, not me, whole team were like on the drugs. And I still have no idea why they would have to do this, because those guys would lose anyways. They had no idea about the ground fighting. And in my case, I mean, with a broken hand, I tried to get the leg of Renzo, but I couldn't hold the leg. I'm like, and I had a really strong grip. And I'm like, fuck, it can't happen. I mean, come on. I mean, nobody would, you know, get the leg out of my hand. So I concentrate on this grip so much with my useless hand. And that's how I got the kick in the chin. So it was out. But like I said, later, I found a big reason for behind all of it. I had a manager who was a drug addict. He was always with the red eyes, with his nose running. And I was asking him, like, what's going on with you? Like, why are you? He said, oh, I had a lot of work. I had to sleep. I didn't sleep. And everyone in the MMA community knew that he's a drug addict. And they would give him under the table like a few grand to buy drugs. And he could get me anywhere. That's how I got to hands the fight in the 8 days after Marco Ruas. And that's how I got to Goodridge, Japan, in, I think, 9 days after winning Sean Alvarez in Brazil.